Hello guys, my name is Adam Pips, and today we're going to be taking a look at the Smith Corona SL500 typewriter. Now, the Smith Corona SL500 typewriter is your average 80s typewriter, but there's a catch. It is electronic, as you probably saw in the video, in the intro. Because code and center, and then it types. So, here I have the red and gray version, but there also was a blue line and gray version.
There's not really a difference between them, except for obviously the color right there, but there is no other color main, like, whole different color.
So as you can see, this is the Smith Corona SL500, and it has your standard keyboard and your standard numbers, and this is a mechanical keyboard, as you can hear. And as your standard numbers, plus, equals, underscore, dash, a little backspace key, because this, again, doesn't erase anything you've had on here. It just goes back a space. So, like, say, for example, you accidentally made a space, just hit, and that's all it would do. Here's the extraordinarily large return key. Here are your two shift keys. This one is slightly smaller, probably because I'm not used to using that one as much as I am with the bigger one on the left. So up here is your tab button. I'm not sure what tab S means, but I definitely know it is another tab option. Here is your lock key, which is basically your caps lock. But what's interesting about this key is that it does light up. And what's interesting about it is that you can do anything. Just if you hit the shift key, then you obviously go back into lowercase mode as you would on any other normal word processor. But when you'd hit lock, you would be able to hit these keys. And instead of 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, it would be the exclamation point, the at symbol, the hashtag, slash, number, slash, yeah, I don't know, and the money sign. And up here are your nice little handy controls, like the pitch. I don't really know what that means yet, but I'll have to study on that. The line space, I think these are inches, centimeters, I still don't know. Index, up and down, don't know what that means. Script, sub, and super, again, don't know what that means. An auto, center, and return. Center would be like what I just did, so I hit code, and then I hit zero, because then that matches up with center, and then I could type whatever I want, and my message, and the note was a little too long. That was supposed to say typewriter, but it was so long that it couldn't even fit on the paper. Maybe because this is a composition notebook paper, I don't know. Yeah. So, if you hit the code button, codes, and then also these little red keys here around, if you hit code and you hit that specific letter, it will create, like, for example, the different brackets instead of you and I. That sounds weird, but okay. And it is the QWERTY keyboard layout. So now let's take a look under the hood. So under here, it's a little hard to open. Once you get it open, it's actually really simple under here. You have your replaceable text ribbon, if I can get it out of the machine. There you go. Here's your text ribbon that is replaceable. And you can see what you have last typed. As you can see, I wrote typewriter. And here's where the letters, or like where the spindle spins this around, so it has more space. And it's pretty basic. So over here, there's this little push button, and it literally says push. If you push it, this comes out. And then your beautiful daisy wheel cartridge comes out. And this is what types all the characters on your typewriter. This one is... Hold on a second. I gotta turn on my lamp. This one is... Regency 10. So, that's the type of font that they would use for this. I still can't believe that all these letters fit, or all the characters on this giant, well, not giant, but like pretty big keyboard, fit on one little daisy wheel. Because you have to count for the capitals too. This is the way. So all you have to do is just shove it back in. And then just push this. Don't push that button. You gotta push this back up. And then push button all you want. And now you put in your age correctable thing back in. Or more like your ink ribbon. And that's really it. So let's just take that off. Let's get the best view as possible. So, I'm gonna take the camera off the tripod for a second. There we go. Excuse the clothes. But, down here, you have your belt mechanism for the typewriter. I think it's the, yeah, that is the belt mechanism. Or, it's something like that. So, it actually is very, it's in very good shape still. And, yeah. So, this does have a correcting feature, but I don't know where it is. And there's also a warning message. So, it says, warning, keep fingers, hair, jewelry, etc. away from this area while machine is in operation. Yeah. That goes to show how much dust is in a 1980s printer. Well, kinda printer. But yeah, there's the warning label, and now we are just going to... Hey, that's the belt? Kinda. Kind of the belt. I'm not exactly sure where the belt mechanism is, but it doesn't really matter. So, that's the side that goes back here. If it would like to go in for me, this doesn't like me. Hold on a second, guys. I'll be right back. Okay, now I have the typewriter perfectly, or the everything perfectly assembled back in. And there's this little switch right here. I don't know exactly what it does, but it probably keeps the machine spring loaded or something. Also, it has a nice roller. And turnkey, it makes this roll automatically. So, in this,
is the lock for your paper. So this would be open, so you can put it in, and then this would be closed, so you can reel it out. So, down here, we have the correct and word eraser keys. Now, these keys are, there we go. These keys are pretty special because what those keys do is they, when you hit them, correct means I'm pretty sure it goes back and it goes up and erases the word. Word eraser, I think, does the same thing. Either that or it's just a placeholder. But it does click. It also has half space. I don't know why it says, oh wait, because code, then you hit half space. And then, yeah. Oops. Camera's about to fall off the tripod there. Right, anyway, thanks for watching my review on the Smith Corona SL500 typewriter.